Ink crew, it's your boy Isaiah here, man. We're gonna be reacting to Kenya Alexis not accepting DDG / Daryl's apology between the situations between them two. There's no sides between. I'm gonna be honest. I'm gonna be 100%, you know, clear that I'm not choosing nobody's side. I'm not in this. I'm not choosing nobody's side. That's it. I'm just reacting to this video. And I'm putting my opinion and my thoughts of it, you know, to this situation. But let's watch the video, and I hope you guys enjoy. Before we start this video, man, keep in mind that this girl is actually one of my woman crush ones. Nah, she's one of my YouTube crushes, man. She kind of cute, but I'm gonna see what's going on, like what's really happening with, you know, the situation. So let's start this video. And here we go.
That video was like 2.5 hours when I finished filming. Then to edit it took like 2 days. Like, are you fucking kidding me? I'm not making another video. So I'm just gonna come in here and talk about it. I already know that there's like 5 people who are screen recording this damn Instagram live, and they're gonna post it back up on YouTube. I already see it. It's gonna be up in the next hour on somebody's channel. So there, if you miss it, you could go watch it on there, whatever. But someone even commented, what's your opinion on DDG apologizing? That's what I'm gonna talk about. It's fake as fuck. That apology is a half-ass apology, and I'm gonna say right now from the start, and then I'll talk. Do I accept your apology, Daryl? Hell fucking no. You can take that apology and shove it up your fucking ass, to be honest. Why don't I accept this apology?
Alright, yo, hold on. I sent the apology yesterday. He posted that video up last yesterday. This man tried to apologize to each and every person, like, which was, like, pretty much basically it was the girls that was in the, that he was trying to apologize to the girls and stuff for, like, you know, the situation that he went through with them. And, like, you know, he was trying to apologize to them to see that, you know, he was trying to apologize because he wanted to, like, you know, say sorry to them with the situation that, you know, they were going through, actually with him. But they, like, I don't know how to explain it, but, like, yeah, he had to apologize to a lot of them, too. So, it's like, you know, they gotta do what they gotta do. So, and then, yeah.
First of all, people are like, oh my god, he's such a real nigga because he apologized and blah, blah, blah. He didn't even apologize. If you listen to his apology, the only person he really apologized to is Selena, which she doesn't even deserve an apology, in my opinion. But if you listen to the apology, he tells Kelly, I'm sorry you feel that way. Telling someone I'm sorry you feel that way is not an apology. That's like me saying, you're ugly as fuck, and then you start crying, and I'm like, I'm sorry you felt offended. That's not an apology. That's me saying, I'm sorry that you felt offended. But what I said was still, like, right. That's not an apology. Instead, you say, you know what? I'm sorry I made you feel that way. I'm sorry that I said those words.
I feel like you said that yesterday.
That's an apology.
That's what he probably said yesterday. I don't know why she keeps saying.
What kind of apology is that? Number two, this boy posted a picture earlier today of me dancing on his, from a vlog. It's a screenshot from a vlog of me dancing on his lap. And the caption was, the real reason you got raped. Just because of that, like, I will never have respect for this dude ever again in my life. Like,
you
the
are
real
savage,
reason I got raped,
man,
and
you
posted a picture of me sitting on
hold
your lap.
Hold on, bro. DDG, you are savage, boy. Daryl, damn. Damn, Daryl. Jeez. You had to do that, man? That's not, man. Man, I ain't got nothing to say about that. I'm just gonna watch this video and just shut my mouth. That's it. This shit is real right now. Shit is for real, like, the real right now. Shit is just real, man.
Just to clarify, I never got raped. If you actually watched the story, it's about how I almost got raped. The title literally says almost got raped. But the fact that you even want to say, like, I put myself in a position to be raped? Are you kidding me right now? So your apology didn't even include that. You didn't even want to mention that.
Shout out to Sour Patch, man.
But the fact that said earlier today, you easily posted a picture talking about the real reason you got raped, and then literally a couple hours later you posted a video saying you apologized and you really felt. Usually it takes someone at least a day to actually realize where they fucked up, not 2 hours, because literally, like, you probably filmed the video a couple hours after because people were on your ass about all the bullshit you were pulling. Like, literally, everybody was on Daryl's ass because they were saying he's a fucked up person for all the shit he did. So, it's funny to me how you really posted a video a couple hours later talking about, I'm sorry, when literally just this afternoon, you were talking about the real reason I got raped, saying basically I deserve to be raped. Like, who does that? I'm pretty sure if someone posted a picture of your mom sitting on someone's lap and said the real reason she got raped, you would go off.
No,
like,
you would probably want to kill somebody. Like, that's so fucked up. You gotta be careful with that mom stuff right there.
The apology is enough to make me be like, oh my god, yes, I'm sorry. Like, I mean, I accept the apology. Like, yes. Do I look stupid to you? You graduated as a valedictorian. You're not stupid. So the fact that you think I'm stupid enough to be like, oh, I accept that apology, if any of those girls that you mentioned in that video are stupid enough to accept that apology, then they're just dumb. Because none of those apologies were real except for the one for Selena. But like I said, you've been kissing her ass from day one. So obviously she gets like an apology because she didn't apologize for what reason. I'm sorry that damn, man. You gotta put Selena. Yo, this is one thing I don't get with the best friend thing right here with between her and Selena, man. Chandler and Selena. I mean, I've been watching her vlogs and all that. Her and Selena's like tight like this, yo. And for real, like, I'm just like looking at it. I'm like, yo, y'all went from being so close, like, y'all was like sisters to the point where, like, you know, they mean to each other and stuff like that. I'm like, bruh, where did this world go wrong, man? When did we all start hating each other? Can we all just get along? Like, dang. What's wrong with us, man? I swear, man, what's wrong with us? We gonna become, I don't know what's gonna happen to our generation, especially yours generation too, Chandler. Like, what's gonna happen? We ain't taking no apologies? What's wrong with you? I do believe she deserves that apology, but it's like, out of everyone that deserves an apology, she was probably the last person on that list who deserves an apology. So the fact that hers was like the only one that seemed sincere is so fucked up. So, I'm not gonna stay on here much longer. I just wanna say, your apology was half-assed. Do I accept it? No. Am I gonna move on with my life? Yes. But if you feel like you need to apologize and your guilty conscience feels like you want to apologize, or if you feel like that was a good enough apology, then you know what? Good for you. I'm glad you got that off your back. But just, like, don't talk to me ever again. But if you eventually come to your senses and realize that I'm not a dumbass like you thought I was, and you decide you want to actually give a sincere apology, you have my phone number, which I also don't understand. He has every single one of these girls' numbers. We already know he has my number. We know he has Kelly's number. We definitely know he has Selena's number. And he mentioned in the video that Desiree called him, so he has her phone number. If you really honestly want to apologize to someone, you text them, you call them, or you say, call them, or you say, let's meet in person. You don't post a video on YouTube talking about, guys, first I want to say I'm sorry to you guys and blah, 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 because, like,
you got a point about that, because, like, nowadays, we gotta be, like, I don't know, like, he kind of messed up on that one right there, because you got a point with that one. You gotta apologize to them, like, in person or something, because I remember watching Kelly's video, too, and she was like, you know, the best thing to do was, like, she wanted to, like, text him and call him or something, like, meet in person, just talk to him or something. And I remember she was talking about that, why she stopped hanging out with Daryl and stuff like that, man. But at the same time, you know, I get, like, Chandler's mad at her friend, which is Selena, where, like, the situation that happened in VidCon, because it was a lot of drama I heard that was in VidCon between that group right there, yo. It's like a circle. And it's like, man, when I see even Kelly said she didn't even want to be in that group, bro. I feel you. I feel Miss Sweet. I feel you, Miss Sweet, man. I feel you. I would have ran away too. If I was in, I would have been getting out of there too. Shoot. I ain't in this situation. That's between y'all three and your little circle. Not y'all three. Y'all four actually in your little circle right there. I'm walking away. That's it. I'm packing my stuff and I'm leaving. So, yeah, in that situation right there. Alright guys, I want to spread my opinion to this video. The thing I hate about the YouTube community right now, especially where our YouTube community is right now, is that like it's so much drama. It's like the drama is all over the place. I don't even know what's going on. It's like a lot of people getting into too many drama situations. It's just like, yo, it's like to entertain, you know, the fans. I feel like, you know, the drama, they just want to cause more drama by intending the fans. Keep in mind, my opinion to her situation is that, like, yeah, she had a little point about, hey, you didn't call nobody and tell nobody that, hey, you know, you didn't call us or do anything about it. You know what I mean? Like, she just didn't, like, not call us, but like meet them, call them or something. I just said that, but yeah. And like, I feel so bad about it because, like, you know, I didn't feel so bad, but like, why I'd say feel so bad, but like, to my opinion, you know, if he didn't do that, it was just like, still, you should have just took the apologies because he was sorry. Like, he just, in my opinion, even when he said it, like, he was just like, man, I don't want to deal with the drama with the girls. And to me, he really interacts, it's like, you gotta understand guys, especially men, especially all men, interacting with a girl is like, you know, you'd have something in common. Like, it's better than interacting with like a boy to boy sometimes. Like, in all, like in some situations, yeah, but in reality, it's like when somebody tried to say sorry to you and stuff like that, you wouldn't take the apology. And I feel like, you know, it's not just bitterness. It's a lot of sourness going on into their situation. Like, it's a lot of sour faces, a lot of pissiness. I feel like somebody gonna get into a fight or something. Like, somebody gonna beat one another up. Somebody gonna end up slapping somebody, or somebody gonna end up getting, you know what. So, yeah. But that's my opinion. I'm about to roll out. I think I'm gonna be making 3 videos tonight. 3 little clips. Before I actually go, this week on Friday, Saturday, I am going to Guyana again. I'm going there for vacation. And basically, what's going to happen, if for some people that doesn't know where Guyana is, it's in South America. So, for some reason, you know, Guyana right now, like, for me, it's gonna be hard for me to like upload videos and stuff, because what I'm gonna do is like take the vacation. It's a 2-week vacation. If I don't post anything in less than 2 weeks, then by the 23rd, I'm gonna post something, and I'm gonna post something about, you know, the vlogs and everything. Like, I'm gonna post something about, you know, what we had in Guyana and stuff, and you know, all that. But we're gonna keep everything cool. I'm gonna keep everything updated with you guys of what's going on that trip. But yeah. Alright, man. Tune in next time, because we're gonna have another reaction video. And hope you guys like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys when I see you guys. Peace. Salute. Shalom.